Hello, I am Wanderer001, and this is my review of the AVerMedia Live Gamer Mini GC311. Now, I will admit I was a little naive when it came to gaming capture cards. I honestly thought that they were something that lived inside the computer that you were streaming off of. Little did I know that there were portable versions of gaming capture cards. So this one, from AVerMedia, I will disclose, I did not purchase on my own, but it also was not sent to me by AVerMedia. My wife entered a contest that a Twitch streamer was holding, Bog Otter, awesome Twitch streamer, you should check him out, link in the description below to his YouTube page, and if you like what you see there, you can go follow him on Twitch. But she won a contest, and what she won was the live stream duo pack by AVerMedia. One of the components in that pack was this streaming card. So I get to test it out and have set her up for streaming. In fact, she has already done a test streaming run. One of the particular things about this capture card is that it will allow you to capture full 1080, 60 frames a second. Yes, I know there are 4K options out there, but look at it. It's small, it's light. If you don't believe me how small it is, here's a deck of cards. Here is the capture card on the deck of cards. It is ridiculously small and lightweight. So on the front, flat matte plastic finish. This is a light bar indicator just to let you know what is going on with the device. For example, if it's solid blue, it's ready. If it's flashing red, it's recording. If it's slow flashing blue, it's streaming. Fast flashing red, disk is almost full. Flashing blue, installing drivers. Solid red, disk is full. So this is going to be paired with your computer. No light means it's error, device abnormality. Or in this case, the device is not plugged in. Coming around to the bottom, you have four little rubberized feet pad to help it stay in place. And then here is the important part. Your HDMI out, your HDMI in, and your USB 2.0, not 3.0, port. And this is how you're going to power the device. There's also a little reset button right there. This is a standalone capture card. However, you do use your computer as an intermediary for running this particular thing. It is plug and play. You can plug it right into your computer and drivers are downloaded to your computer. However, there also is software that you can download to update the drivers on your computer and make this talk a little better. Now, the power usage back here is provided via the included 5-foot braided cable. I'm not a super fan of braided cables and I think that they are overhyped, but it is included. What is not included are HDMI cables. So you will have to either have extra ones lying around or plan ahead like I did and purchase some extras. One of the issues that I have found with this particular capture card is because it's so lightweight, if you have heavier cableage, you're actually not going to be sitting flat on the surface. They'll be cocked. I mean, it's a minor consideration. Now, because this is part of the streamer duo pack, the other portion of what comes just for the capture card is this. And normally I don't show this, but I just want you to realize for somebody who has no experience whatsoever, you get the device, the cable, and then a quick start guide, which pretty much has, here's what's in the box, here's what's on the back, this is your light indicator, there you go, how to plug it in, and that's it, then different languages. So if this is your first time with a capture card, you may want to do a little more research ahead of time for troubleshooting. Now, a lot of you may be looking at this as a means of capturing video from your PlayStation so that you can either stream or post to YouTube. However, I, being a YouTube creator, found another purpose that I can use this for, and that is for actually capturing the screen when I'm reviewing set-top boxes like Roku or Nvidia Shield. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually show you the difference between my old setup, which was pretty much pointing my camera at the TV set, versus what I got using the AVerMedia capture card here. To give you an example of why, even if you're not a game streamer, something like this could actually be extraordinarily valuable to you. So here we go, a comparison of before and after of using a capture card and not using a capture card. Apps. Select this, and then it will show us all of our apps, and then we can get more from the Play Store.
So these are things that were
in progress. You'll also notice that the color shifted a little bit when I came from up top to my Play Next area. But this will just be the next up thing, so you kind of get an idea of things that have been watching. You'll see what channel they were on. So these were on Twitch, this was on Sling, all the way at the end there, that was Pluto. So that's. So if I came up to something and hypothetically, here we go, next item down is Peacock Picks. So if I select this, I can add to my watch list. I can see all of the episodes.
So hopefully that comparison was helpful from a creator standpoint. Obviously, the capture card, while it's going to do all the heavy lifting itself, you still do need to have software that will allow the capture card to record and do what it does. Now, the beauty of AVerMedia here is it's very agnostic as to what it can be used with. You can use it with Streamlabs OBS, you can use it with OBS Classic, and XSplit. AVerMedia also has their own recording software, which I will admit is very intuitive for the first-time streamer or video recorder, because I will admit, OBS is a bit of a handful to set up if you're a novice. So let's take a look at the software that you can use to record using your AVerMedia capture card.
What we're looking at here is the AVerMedia Rec Central for recording software. So this is one of the good things that you get out of the box with your capture card or the streaming duo, is you have access to this record software. Now, I will say I have mixed feelings about the software, only in that, one, while the software is really simple and easy to set up, if you look down here in the lower right-hand corner, it is taxing my computer. And while my computer is a little older, I did build it to be future-proof. So what do I mean by future-proof? Well, in the case of this particular laptop, I have a Core i7-6820HK CPU, and I have 64 gigabytes of RAM, and an NVIDIA GeForce GTX 980M. And here you can see in the lower right-hand corner, I'm using up 40% of my CPU just for this program, and 33 gigabytes of RAM. This is not including the OBS software that I'm running right now to record this particular setup. Now, I will say, just having this on and I'm not streaming anything or recording anything, this is using 19,600 megabytes and 14, almost 15% of my CPU. In a similar setup using OBS, and actually recording, I use 800 megabits worth of memory and much less CPU. So just know that if you're using an older system, you may run into problems actually streaming. Now in the background here, you've just been watching my Roku background as it's cycling, but let's take a look at what we can actually do with the software should you have a computer that actually can support running it. So what we're looking at here is the main capture area. You have single capture, you have multi. Multi will allow you to add layers, so a camera. Right now I'm on single because I just need this to capture what's on my TV set, or in your case, the PlayStation or Xbox, whatever you're trying to capture off of your TV. Here we're indicating the Live Gamer Mini. We can always come over here and edit anything. So here we go, quick little options. We're not going to mess with that too much. Over here on the right, you have record, stream, and then multi-stream. You have different recording profiles that you can set up. Right now I'm on optimal, and it's doing 1920 by 1080 at 59.9 frames a second. Here, you can actually see the available space that you have on your hard drive. So if you have multiple hard drives like I do, you can indicate to the hard drive that actually has the most space for saving. Here you can see there is a microphone mute button, and you can see you can mess with your levels right there, as well as audio that you're getting. You also have your mute device preview. You've got your audio mixer here, so opening this up will let you really dig in and change settings as you like. And right here, you have full screen mode. The beauty of this program is that it's really start setup. There's even a wizard that you walk through right here. If you ever need to reset up the wizard, you click on that and you can set it up streaming, recording, and it walks you through most of the settings. Now, one of the other things I like is this help button. It actually has a visual overlay as to what the individual components mean. So if this is the first time you're messing with any type of streaming software, this would be really good to kind of help you get started. You can enable always on top mode, or you can have a minimized mode. We've been operating in the maximum mode so that we could see all of our options. Over here, coming to the wheel, we just click on settings and it will bring us into our settings. You have options for general, shortcuts if you want. I will admit, I did not use shortcuts in OBS until much later in my usage of OBS. I highly recommend setting up shortcuts. It'll save you a lot of time, especially if you're using a single monitor setup and you're trying to play a game. Profile management, you can export or import your profiles, and then you have about. One of the interesting things is you have a media share option. So if you wished to share media, and here you go, this is media that I have just kind of sitting there from tests, but you can share that right through the system. And then we're going to hit our record button. This middle button, if you select it, will actually bring you to the AVerMedia website for more information. Now, this is a separate download, and it did not come pre-installed with the drivers for the capture card. But just know, if you're starting out and you don't want to necessarily try to set up OBS Studio on your own or look through a guide, this is a very simple, straightforward, quick setup for streaming, setup for recording software. Again, your computer will have to be a little beefier in order to handle it. So when you're ready, all you would do is you'd come here, click record, or that would be stream if you were on the streaming option. You can select for snapshots if you so chose, and then you would watch your countdown timer here as you record and lose writable space. But don't worry, if you pay attention to your capture card and don't see your numbers here, once it starts blinking red, you'll know that you're getting kind of close to full hard drive and you should stop streaming. So again, really simple to use, straightforward streaming software that can be used with your AVerMedia capture card.
So as long as you have a computer that can support using AVerMedia software, you've got a fairly simplistic means of capturing gameplay or set-top boxes. However, again, it is compatible with other types of software, so if you don't want to use AVerMedia's, you don't have to. That's the beauty of this capture card and AVerMedia in general. Don't think that I'm going to leave you with just software and video recording from a set-top box. Obviously, if you're looking at this, you're probably thinking about streaming on Twitch or one of the other many game streaming platforms. So let me show you some actual gameplay footage using this capture card, again, in full 1080, 60 frames a second.
Can you keep up?
Now, I'm sure there are those out there that might be able to find fault with the way that that looks. However, I want you to keep in mind that the Live Gamer Mini here is made for people who are just starting out and don't necessarily have a lot of money to spend on more robust game capture systems. So that leads us to the question of how much does the AVerMedia Live Gamer Mini cost? Well, separately, this costs $130. Keep in mind, something like the Elgato system, which again, if you go to their lower end, 1080, 60 frames a second, capture card, will run you somewhere around $200. So for those that are just starting out, trying to get into either live streaming or even YouTubing, something like this at $130 is not terrible for full 1080, 60 frames a second. I will admit I'm being very vague on the technical specs of this particular capture card, mainly because I want to use this review as a means of telling you my experiences without bogging you down with all the technical jargon, especially if you might just be starting your adventures into looking into using a capture card. What I can say from my experiences both using it for YouTube and my wife's trying out a test stream with it is a very capable capture card and is well worth looking into, especially if you're just starting out. So thanks again to Bog Otter for the contest win for my wife. Again, links in the description area below if you're interested in checking him out. As well as, if you're looking for this particular capture card, I will have a link in the description where you can pick it up on Amazon. With that being said, I highly recommend the AVerMedia Live Gamer Mini GC311. I have been Wanderer001. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the area below. And as always, thanks for watching.